Thank you.
I was bummed that Carol Burnett wasn't Jewish.
Me too.
Yeah.
Me too. She has the personality of a Jew.
Yeah.
I can't get past that Phyllis Diller isn't Jewish.
I know.
That
Diller
is
sounds Jewish.
Oh, I thought Penny Marshall was Jewish.
So did everyone think Penny Marshall
was
Jewish.
She's not Jewish?
No.
Italian. Oh, she's an honorary Jew.
But she's such an honorary Jew.
It's a very big thing among Jews when someone's Jewish. So whatever comic or whoever in the performing world or any world was Jewish was a huge deal. Molly Picon, my uncle doesn't shut up. Molly Picon was the greatest talent. She did everything. She was an acrobat. She played the piano. I mean,
she had a Yiddish chein, which is Jewish charm that only she possessed.
Fanny Brice couldn't be the prettiest girl on the stage, but she could be the funniest. She was the first woman who was willing to play the clown. She's a first-generation American, and certainly a driving force in her life was to make it.
Sophie Tucker had so much brio and so much self-knowledge.
Sometimes she would sneak a Yiddish word in just to keep them on their guard.
She was not afraid to be saucy and naughty long before the women's lib movement.
Joan Rivers.
It was all men in these clubs.
They just didn't trust women.
She just went up there and did stand-up. She was hilarious, and then she got really ballsy.
No one discusses that.
Incredibly brave.
Gilda Radner was exploding all over American living rooms all over the place.
Being Jewish and a comedian, you were supposed to be unattractive, and you were supposed to make jokes at your own expense. Her point was, excuse me, I am a beautiful girl, and I'm also funny. Live with it.
When we think of Jewish comics, we usually think of male comics with their humor that depicted Jewish mothers and young Jewish girls as selfish and manipulative.
And they are always portrayed as a joke on the stage.
It took a long line of Jewish women who had show business in their hearts and souls to turn this around, and they made a statement.
I'm going to give that woman her dignity.
Wendy thought of herself as a comedy writer, but she felt very strongly that comedy was much broader a category than just fun and jokes.
People always came up to Wendy and said, I love you, Wendy.
Because she had touched their lives with her work.